Definitely right. Big.
We right back in.
He was very, dude, that was his first weekly.
That was his first week. Yeah, because
he came to
nice.
Pound. He came to Pound and
yeah, he just started going to tournaments. He just started going to
Bro, you got top five of your first, like, tournament? I mean, Pound I'm not going to include because that was Super Major.
Yeah, because he's nice.
My man was
sardines for dinner. He's at home.
No, my man
watching,
is nice.
He's watching Xanadu's. Woo! But then he comes here and he starts putting in work.
Dude,
but
I was
speaking
so
of dudes who put in work. Winners finals, ZD versus Passer.
No, I'm joking. But you're absolutely correct. And this is wild because, you know, 2-3 months ago, you'd have been like, yeah, ZD got this free. ZD can go whoever he wants. And then Pathrin said, by the way, do you know who I am?
Yeah, Pathrin's been glowing up as of late. He's been doing really solidly against Dexter and holding his own against ZD as well. It's tough to beat him. He certainly he knows what he's doing with this character without a doubt.
Yeah, very, very solid. ZD's been going a lot more Wolf recently, which I kind of respect. Wolf is a bit easier of a character than Fox.
And he's a lot less punishing as well.
Yeah.
If you mess up. I mean, sure, Fox is incredibly strong.
Yeah, but if you mess up, like, you get exploited so hard.
Yeah.
Whether it's juggles, whether it's, you know, edge guarded, etc. Wolf don't worry about it. And Wolf kills a lot earlier and safer. And he got that nice laser.
Yeah, only problem is he kind of lacks the confirms at a certain, once they get past a certain, once they get to like 100, it's a little bit hard. So like at this point, ZD, he almost got that up smash, but surprisingly didn't take out Catherine's stock. Wow, he jumps into that. He waited, now let's talk about that. My man waited for the C4 to get detonated. And then he says there. And then he jumps into it anyway, ZD. Sir, wait, it's all right, it's okay. I know that nobody's perfect, but.
He almost did it to him. That was wild.
Yeah, nice spot dodge and up tilt.
I like that read right there. You know, Pathrin was like, yo, I'm gonna definitely do the one jab. Oh my God, he threw him into it again.
Yeah, he's gonna get those.
They're exploding everywhere.
Yeah, he's gonna rack up that damage.
Okay, by the way, why is Snake's down air, which does like 20% frame three?
And auto cancels.
Why? Why do you have a frame three out of shield option?
It's also, he can Fox cop it with it too. He can Fox cop it with it.
Bro, let's be real. That's like a fourth of your health. That's more over a fourth. That might be a third. I like that up smash.
Another up smash, but yeah, Snake is just mad heavy and he falls fast, so he's not going to be dying to that super easily, but up tilt all the same. Doesn't matter who you are. If you have 120,
yeah. All right, but this isn't the worst spot for ZD. I like the back, though. So many Wolves will, like, they're do down throw or forward throw, and I'm just like, put him off stage. Look what he got off of that.
Straight up.
The back throw didn't kill, but it put him in such a poor position he was able to capitalize.
Yeah, that's something that a lot of players should do. Like, if you get a grab on somebody, you don't always got to go for your grab confirm. You don't always got to go for your kill, like, a kill throw that might kill, might not kill.
Yeah.
Like throws in this game for positioning are incredibly good with how bad air dodging is.
Exactly. And you only get one. Like, my man is chasing. Okay. Okay, I see you. You out here. Oh, he almost did it to him, but he's still not done. Let me find out humans aren't the highest on the food chain anymore.
Oh, okay. He really
he
wanted
should die
that.
For it. Man, I wish he would have.
Now, he did blow up the Cypher, but Pathrin was ready with a preemptive directional air dodge to get to the ledge. So he was not getting caught with that, and he jumps out of the way of that cross up.
Yo, why my man turn up like this? Calm down.
That forward air straight up grazed him. He's going to steal that C4 that time.
And it, of course, you know, ZD definitely has a huge lead right now. Why did I feel like he was going to F smash? I don't know why. ZD has a lead, but, you know, Pathrin could turn around in a second, get ZD off stage, use that Nikita. Oh, my God.
I mean, do you believe in magic logic?
Yo, I believe it.
Like, one forward smash.
One forward smash, one back throw off stage. If he throws him off stage, get the Nikita.
Yep.
Okay.
It's even.
I'm clinched. I'm clinched right now. I'm shook.
All right. Oh, that's an overshare, dog. Here we go. Neutral back air. Gonna do it. Yeah, in neutral, like, he's like straight up. That's when Wolf is just gonna be like, all right, I can't get my kill confirms. And I know that if I get in your face, I can straight up die.
Yeah.
So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna space this aerial kill move. And if you run into it, hey, it's your fault, dog. It's all your fault.
And that's one of the things that Wolf has going for him that makes him such a difficult character to fight. So many safe buttons that will kill you. You know, that back air, you're just like, I would like to punish it, but I have to heavy commit to punishing it. And all he has to do is drift a little to the left, a little to the right, mess it all up, change the timing. So difficult.
100%. It's real tough to deal with.
But kudos to ZD for making that comeback, because it was looking grim at first. Pathrin was here to play, but ZD turned it up when he needed to. Takes game number one of this set. Yo, why 16, though? Was that deserved? Oh, my God. I'm loving what I'm seeing right now. God damn.
That was almost a 10% death. I said 10%. I meant 10 seconds. I'm sorry.
Yo. The 2B continued combo. My man has still not been hit yet. Take your grenade, too. I don't know how you're coming back. Okay. Oh, yo, that's how he gets his first damage.
That's still an easy upset. Right.
But he got that 7.5. You know, this is little things that count.
Yeah, good stuff from ZD. That's really good timing on that ledge get up to get that up smash.
And I like the dash attack to pick up the grenade and hit Snake in the process.
Now, this is a best of five set, so there's still time for Pathfinder to adapt, even though I'm going to be completely real with you because it's the grind.
I thought you were going to say it's still time for more Twitch clips, but I feel you.
Yeah, it is. I mean, when ZD's on, it's always time for Twitch. I mean, Twitch clips.
Yeah, but at this point,
all right. Now, I was going to say you should start thinking about your counter pick because PS1 clearly is not the move to set.
You're going to down air. Oh, my God.
Nerf, by the way.
Talk to him.
Yeah, at this point, like I was gonna say that Pathfinder's kind of bringing it back, you know, but then ZD, nah.
Right, he's starting to feel himself a bit too much. My man went for that hard read right there. Pathfinder at least didn't give up his game plan. Look at that, up tilt my way to victory. I'm not giving up on it. Do it again.
Like that wasn't even kill percent for an up tilt.
It was.
He's begging. Yeah. He's just begging ZD.
Please hold up.
Please die. Can you jump into the blast zone for me?
Now I have seen Pathfinder, you know, make some of these comebacks before, like reverse 3-0s. So. It is possible. Can't count him out yet, but I'm going to be real. God.
Another one. Another back air.
That's
just
rough.
Keep connecting.
That's rough.
They keep connecting.
That's rough.
And that's a sad thing with Snake, dog, because like some characters, you can mix up recovery and stuff. Like, you know, you got all this. But with Snake, you want to mix it up.
You want to air dodge now or later?
Pretty much air dodge now or later, dog. I mean, like, yeah, you gotta go high.
And now's not always an option. So, game number 3, ZD looking to make this a 30 and a handshake.
Yeah, he's looking to make a little bit more, like, a little bit more than 30 tonight.
Ooh, you're right. I mean, he's guaranteed at least more than that right now, right?
Yeah, but he's trying to, like,
he's trying to at least,
like, times 10 that.
Feel that. Oh, I'm liking this, Pathfinder. You displayed some patience. You went forward. You took damage. Chill, bro. Oh, no. You shouldn't have went forward. Look what happens when you go forward.
One hit. If you get touched once in this matchup as Snake, then that's just monumental damage. Sure, Pathfinder can certainly make up for it, but those can add up real quick. And we were talking earlier about how bad Snake disadvantageous state is when you're trying to get off the ledge. You're trying to recover back on stage when Wolf's edge guarding you. He's going to get through that mortar. Wow!
I'm loving this. That was he's done. As a matter of fact, ZD has not been back on stage.
Another nair through the mortar.
Yeah, so Wolf can always do that. Pathfinder's aware of it, so he's kind of positioning himself to punish the nair after.
That's a really good play from Pathfinder, and I do see that he's kind of walking around and like putting himself in a favorable spot. Oh wow, he's gonna get that. That's the one thing that
he. Yeah. Oh no, it's on stage.
The problem is he teched it, but he accidentally was holding his control stick input, so it came out as a wall jump. Wow, going for everything. And he gets the upbeat of the ledge.
Correct. I've been telling people, you know, essentially, the new meta, you need to just tech without a direction because we're so used to just worrying about getting the tech off.
Straight up.
But now we have to go to the next level. We got to say, I'm going to tech in place.
Yeah, the problem is, though, because you kind of have to hold the direction with LSI because you have with launch speed influence to make it more techable, you want to do LSI. You want to hold the control stick in a certain direction.
Go,
yeah, you got to – it takes reflexes, dog. You got to, like, okay, when this freeze frame ends, that's when I'm releasing my control stick and that's when I'm definitely not about to do a wall jump.
And, you know, Pathfinder's still in this tied up on the stocks, but ZD, you know, already has him at 126. I was just about to say it, a back air will take it. An up smash wouldn't have, but back air gonna do it a couple times over, as a matter of fact.
Imagine having a back air that's an actual smash attack. And it's stronger than your smash attack.
I wish you were wrong.
That is Wolf Privilege.
I wish you were wrong.
And now Wolf Privilege is also getting awesome. Super duper amount of damage.
Oh my god. Just go up there and upbeat him. You know how hype that would be if he just raw upbeat him right now? Met him at the top of the screen? I would have gave him $1. Ooh, nice parry.
Yeah, good stuff. I'm gonna have to see more of that good stuff because it's looking real dire for Pathfinder right now. It's looking like a solid 30, as you said, Logic.
Yeah.
Looking real rough.
This game's getting old. 30 years, bruh.
Rocky Road like ice cream. Here we go.
All right, I mean, this is a decent start. You're going to need a really hard read, though, to end this stock now. unless he wants to get him to like, well, oh, wait, actually, ooh, he ooh, might be able to, Nikita? Okay, ooh, okay,
all right,
start.
He might back on stage, though. Was that
you got to get this up.
Was that a, okay, I thought he stuck him. I could have sworn I saw a fake glow.
Oh, there's some hope. Smash.
Oh, he just barely doesn't get hit by that down smash. It certainly would have been the set.
All right, I think he should slow it down because you're at 126. You can't afford a damn thing right now, but it might be too little too late because ZD's going to wait for that
if
air
ZD wants, he can just stand. All right, he wants to kill him.
Okay.
But if I'm ZD, I'm straight up griefing you, dog. I'm lasering you until 200. Okay.